Welcome to Technique Friday with Els. Today I'm going to show you a card using our soft finish cardstock featuring the daisy die set, and I'll be demonstrating you how to color and assemble the daisy. So this is the die, so it comes with a solid, an overlay, a leaf, the center of the flower and a stem. I love that die set. So these are two samples. So this is the card I'm going to show you. And this is another card using the daisy without the stem. So here for this one, I use the daisy, the leaves, the ladybug, and then the leafy branch and the entwined circles. Just a fun card to make. Let me put this away. I'm going to show you this one. So first of all, I created a background, and that is the soft finish cardstock, and then with the distress oxide, the broken china. So that's the background. And I'm going to put it on the card, but first I'm going to etch the card, because then that's done already. And I'm using the Mermaid Lagoon for that. And the cardstock I'm using is the Colored Soft Finish Time for Teal. I'm going to etch a little bit on this as well. Oh, hit it on the... And the distress ink, both the regular distress inks as the oxides, work really, really well on our soft finish cardstock. Then let me put that on there already. Then I can build on there when the daisies are done. So just play, if you have the distress oxide inks, just play with it on our soft finish cardstock. You will absolutely love it. It's so much fun to do, because you don't know how it's going to look, and it's always going to be fine. It's always going to be beautiful. And on the sample card here, I have the Belief, which is from the Dream Sentiments. And on this one, I have the Miss You, which comes from the General Sentiments. Okay, so that's the base of the card. So these are the General Sentiments. So now I'm going to color the daisy, and I will first color the leaves and the stems, and I'm going to use the peeled paint for that. Oh, got it already on there. And for the stems, I'm just going to dab a little bit. And for the leaves, I will dab first and then etch, like put a little bit of extra color. So this is all soft finish cardstock. Just dab a little bit. I want to keep it light and fresh, like, you know, give it a little bit of a spring feeling. So don't make it too dark. And then I'm going to kind of etch it a little bit here on the sides. That's that. So that was the peeled paint. So now I'm going to add the Wild Honey using an eyeshadow applicator. So I'm just dipping that in there and kind of spread it out lightly like this from the center out. And that will be covered, that center will be covered by the overlay. And if you kind of want to measure where it's going to go, where it needs to go, you can take the overlay and kind of look how it's going to show. That's enough for sure. Then I'm going to take the overlays. And the overlays I die cut with double-sided adhesive on the back. So that's also soft finish cardstock with a double-sided adhesive already on the back. And then if I'm putting these on here, I kind of take them in my hands. I start lining them up on the right side for me, but I'm left-handed, so you might do it the other way around. But kind of line it up. Then I'm going to take the second one, so the second overlay. And again, I do the same. So I start lining it up on the left, but again, you probably start lining it up. If you're right-handed, you're going to line it up on the right. So that's the daisies now. And then I'm going to color the centers, and I'm going to use the vintage photo for that one. I want to have them a little bit darker. And I have adhesive on the back of those ones already. If I do a circular motion, you see it picks up more of the ink. That's good. Alrighty. I'm going to put that away. And then we can start assembling the card. So I'm going to put that center here. So it also has the adhesive on the back. I'm going to put that on here. That's that one. And then this one. And now we can start assembling the card. So for this one, I'm going to use the kids glue again, because I love that, and because it's a heavier glue and it dries clear. So it's just easy. So I'm going to put a blob of the glue in the back here. And it will take a little bit longer to dry, but you know, in half an hour for sure it's dry. Because I'm using a... Because then I'm just going to position this, and you know, if I'm going to kind of take this card here as well. So you see, so I'm just going to position this one here and kind of press it down at the bottom, because I don't like to use like 3D foam dots for this, because I want it to be like not flat, like not just flat dimensional. I want to have like a little bit, you see, it's a little bit up here and a little bit low there. Oh, I got some, put it there. And then I'm going to use the leaves. I'm just going to only drag the like the bottom of the leaf there, and that's sitting there, that's fine. And then we're going to put a little bit of glue on the top and just a tiny little bit here, because again I want to have it like live. So now I can kind of tilt this a little bit, you see, and I can play with that. That's good. And then this one, same. Just a little bit of glue there. And this can be sliding underneath here. And they kind of come together there. You see, so I can still move that around, which is nice. And then I have two leaves. Again, just drag it through here. And put that one, kind of slide it underneath here. And this is, you know, one of my favorite dies, because just, and I can make them in different colors. Slide this one under here, and that's it. So don't put glue all the way, you see, because you want dimensions. So don't put the glue everywhere, just at the stem, at the bottom of the leaves, a little bit on the stem. And then I need some glue on my bow that I made from twine. So I just took twine and put it on there. And that's it, you see, and then you have your card. So thank you for watching. I've suggested a couple of videos I think you enjoy as well. And don't forget that every Technique Friday with Els video comes with a free downloadable project sheet. See you next time.